Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13 GM, or Golden Master. This is the final version that's going to be released to the public on September 19th, this month. Now, the interesting thing is they've also said that 13.1 would be released on September 30th. And I think the reason for that is there's still some known issues in this one, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. But if you want to install iOS 13 GM, I've actually made a separate video about that because in order to do it, I had to use iTunes. I tried it on about four different devices, removing the profiles, trying it from iOS 13 betas, iOS 13.1 betas. Nothing I did worked, so I had to use iTunes. So I've linked that in the description. That'll help you install it, show you what I had to do. It's not that complicated if you've ever done it before, but you will need the 4 gigabyte file or so to install it on your device. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17A577, and this is the final build of iOS 13. And this will be available on September 19th, like I said, and this particular build does not really include a whole lot new. There are some interesting things, though, and one of those is there is actually 31 known issues according to the notes. So you wouldn't expect there to be that many issues, but that's probably why they're pushing iOS 13.1 as soon as September 30th. So a lot of the issues have not been resolved, and those include issues with Chromecast still, Siri, the Find My app, as well as screen time and a lot more. So just keep that in mind. If you're already on a beta and you want to go to 13 GM, you're probably better off being on iOS 13.1 betas, unless you're on a public build such as 12.4.1. Now, as far as any resolved issues, well, this is a GM, so they're not really going to mention those, but there is a few things to note. And one of those is if you're going to use this version, actually, let me show you on the 6S Plus here, and you'll see performance is quite good. I'll talk about that in a moment. But if I go to Shortcuts, Shortcuts does not have the actual Automations tab here at the bottom. They actually pushed that to 13.1. So if that's something you'll use, wait for 13.1. Also, Announce Siri Messages or Siri Announce Messages is not there. So if we go to Siri down here, Siri in Search, it's just not there. It's not in Settings. It's actually not in 13.1 either. And then many of you may be disappointed to know there's no new wallpaper that are included unless you get one of the new iPhone 11 or 11 Pro devices. So if I go into wallpaper here and go to choose wallpaper, you'll see there's nothing new. Dynamic, they're the same ones, stills, and it's the same on the XR as well, and live as well. So there's nothing new there. However, this is one of the new ones, and so is the one I have on my XR, and I'll link those in the description. Now, there is one piece of information that's pretty interesting, and that is some system code in iOS 13 GM and 13.1. It's called Starboard, and it's the system shell that's designed to run stereo AR or augmented reality. And you wouldn't really need those unless you were looking for a stereo device such as AR glasses. Now, Apple hasn't announced any of these, and of course they're always experimenting, so we may never see them, but it seems like they're still working on some stereo augmented reality glasses. So that could be pretty interesting in the future. We may never know, but hopefully we'll see something like that soon, or at least a little bit of information. Now, iOS 13 GM, like I said, will be out to the public on the 19th with all of the new features you expect, including lyrics in certain songs and things like that. Overall, though, the experience is pretty good. Now, you may have just seen a little bit of lag there, but I was just installing a bunch of apps. Maybe it's finished. I think it has. But overall, performance is quite good. Now, we do have haptic touch, and that's built into the XR. We've got that all over the system. And even with the new iPhones, we get a little bit new UI for the camera as well. I don't think they're going to bring that to the XR or the older devices, but there is a little bit of a redesigned camera app for the newer devices. Other than that, there's not really anything new in any of these devices, but performance is quite good, even on the older devices. So if you were scared of it slowing down your device, 3D touch works like haptic touch. You can see here. You actually can feel it here. It works well, it works fast, but it's not like it was before. You can't push it a little bit and have it pop out. So that part's gone, but the feature's still there and all of the same features are there. You still get landscape and things like that and all of those pop and peak touch, 3D haptic touch features are still there. But overall, it's pretty good. Now, I did run a Geekbench on this just so for those of you that want to see that. Now, I did use Geekbench 4. Geekbench 5 is out. I'll be using that once 13 comes out, and we'll move over to that. But let's take a look at Geekbench. Now, as you can see on the left, I have the iPhone 6S Plus, and on the right, I have the iPhone XR. And these numbers can improve over time, but on the left, I have 2,546 for single core for the 6S Plus and 4,505. Now, for the XR, I have 4,833 for single core and 10,546 for multi-core. If we compare this with the history of what I've run before, you'll see it's a little bit better than some, and sometimes it's worse. It just depends on which one we're looking at, but overall, I think it's pretty good. That's it for iOS 13 GM or Golden Master. We'll see how it is over the next few days. Maybe I'll do a combined follow-up with 13.1. Let me know what you think about that in the comments below, though. Now, if you found anything new that I haven't pointed out, it doesn't seem there's a whole lot, but let me know in the comments below, and also I'll link all of these wallpapers. 9to5Mac actually posted them on their website, so I'll just link you to them. They've got all of them in all the different sizes for the newer iPhones. So I'll link those in the description below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.